Hello and welcome to this Pariah Nexus painting video. In this video, I'm going to show how to paint some of the details featured on the Chronomancer, such as the Chronometron and the orb on his Aeon Stave. Now, by following the methods and techniques in this video, you can easily apply this to other Necron models in your collection. Now, the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model, and as you can see here, I've used Runelord Brass, which is actually a really useful colour if you're going to be painting this model from scratch. Now, the first thing we're going to do is start painting the Chronometron, and we'll do the interior of this first, which is the orb where all the panels are connected to. Now, I'm going to start by base coating it with Corax White. So, all I'm going to do is get myself a small layer brush. I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette, and a little touch of water as well. And then, once I'm happy with that, get a nice point to the brush. A little bit more of a point, that's better. And then, all I'm going to do is then just start painting the interior of that Chronometron. Take your time, you might want to do a couple of coats, and don't worry if you get it on the panels on the outside. There we are with the orb in the centre now base coated. What we're going to do now is move on to applying the rest of the colours. So we're going to start first by using Ethematic Blue, which will coat all over. Once that's dry, in the deeper recesses, we'll be using some Griff Charger Grey. And then at the end, we'll just layer back up on some of those raised details with Corax White. But first of all, let's start with Ethematic Blue. So all I'm going to do is just get a couple of dollops onto my palette. I'm not thinning it down. This is just so I don't get too much on the actual paintbrush and get a decent point to it. So then once I'm happy with that, I'm just going to coat that all over, like so. And again, don't worry about getting on this on other areas of the model at the moment. There we are with the Ethematic Blue now dry. What we're going to do now is get some Griff Charger Grey and then just drop that into some of those deeper recesses. So just moving it around where you've got all these little lines going through the orb and also in the cracks where these actual panels are flying off. There we are with the Griff Charger Grey dry, and we're now going to finish off the orb in the centre by just layering back over the raised details using Corax White. There we are with the orb of the Chronometron now done. What we're going to do is do the exterior of it, so that's the panels that are floating around. So we're going to start first with a base coat of Lupercal Green, then in the recesses we're going to be using Norn Oil, then on the edges we'll start highlighting with Cabalac Green followed by Saberite Green, and then just on the corners we'll do some little dots here and there of Gauze Blaster Green. But first of all, let's start with Lupercal Green. So what I'm going to do is just get a couple of dollops of that, as it's a base paint, and a little bit of water, not too much mind, and then get a good point, and then we're ready to start base coating it. Just take your time, work your way around. You might want to do a couple of coats of this. There we are, I have a couple of coats of Lupercal Green now applied. What I'm going to do now is coat that in Norn Oil, mainly concentrating on those deeper recesses where you've got almost that circuit board effect. Work your way around on all the panels, giving it a nice even coat. There we are with the Norn Oil dry. What we're going to do now is do our first highlight, and this is Cavalite Green. So I'm going to do a broad highlight around the square sections like so. We'll have to go a second time. If you do find they get a bit wibbly wobbly, just use your Lupercal Green and some Norn Oil to tidy back up. We'll just make them a little bit broader and also follow that circuit patternry as well that's going around. There we are with that first highlight now done. What I'm going to now do is use Saberite Green. What I'm going to do here is just use the edge of the brush and run it along the panels. And just take your time, work your way around. If you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up with Cabalite Green. There we are with that highlight of Saberite Green now finished. We're going to finish the Chronometron off just by adding some Gauze Blaster Green just in little corners here and there. And there we are, with Gauze Blaster Green now applied to those corners. What we're going to do now is move on to the orb on his Aeon Stave. So we're going to start first by using Barracknar Burgundy as a base coat. Then on the raised details, we're going to layer that up using Screamer Pink. Then we're going to do some highlighting, starting first with Pink Horror, followed with Empress Children, and then we're going to finish off with little bits of highlights here and there of Fulgrim Pink. But first of all, let's start with Barracknar Burgundy. So what I'm going to do is just get a couple of dollops, as we always do with our base coats, add a little bit of water, and then get my brush to a nice point. And then we're ready to start base coating that orb. So just take your time, work your way around. And again, you might want to do a second coat if a lot of that Runelord Brass is showing through. There we are with the Barracknar Burgundy now applied to the orb. What we're going to now do is layer the raised areas using Screamer Pink. So just avoid those little cracks and little details. There we are with the Screamer Pink now layered. What we're going to now do is start our first highlight. This is going to be quite a thick one, and we're using Pink Horror. What I'm going to do is just start working my way around all those raised details. Now that we've done the first highlight of Pink Horror, we're going to move on to Empress Children. So we're going to aim to make this one a little bit thinner, pick out some of those edges again, and take your time and work your way along. There we are. Now that Emperor's Children has been applied, we're just going to finish off with a few little dots here and there of full grim pink, just to give you some really nice edges, almost like little blink points. There we are, with that highlight now done, the details on our Chronomancer are now completed. Now remember, by following the methods and techniques in this guide, you can easily apply these to other details or models in your Necron collection. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own details on your Chronomancer, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.